See, it's three. Right. It's, we take everything that they got, and they still can't come through.
Right. Two strikes and you're out, boys. But I tell you what, guys.
I'm feeling a little bit magnanimous tonight. I'm feeling
magnanimous.
It's a big word.
It is a big word.
I'll tell you what it means later.
Okay, I'm feeling
it's a little bit sporty. So I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to give Benoit a match anyways. I'm going to show him that none of them can cut the mustard here.
Right.
That's it.
Oh, man. Look, Triple H is on his way out here. He's confident and ready to go one-on-one with Chris Benoit. Benoit has nothing to lose. This match is next on SmackDown. You know the story from earlier on tonight. Triple H gave Dean Malenko, Perry Saturn, Eddie Guerrero, and of course,
I got this. Like, rest of DX, I guess they're just going to sit back and enjoy this.
Triple H gave Saturn, Guerrero, Malenko, and Chris Benoit a chance to get contracts here in the World Wrestling Federation. They had to win 2 out of 3 matches.
Right.
Dean Malenko lost to X-Pac, and then after Eddie Guerrero suffered a dislocated elbow, he and Perry Saturn lost to the New Age Outlaw.
Right, so that should have been it. Should have been all over. This match shouldn't even have taken place, but out of the goodness of the game's heart, I guess he just wants to, you know, Chris Benoit to get to be able to say he had one match here in the WWF, so he's going to go ahead and take on Benoit. I'm worried about him because you know why? Benoit's got absolutely nothing to lose here, and that's dangerous. He could just, I mean, he could go out here and try to make a name for himself by hurting Triple H, just like Guerrero got hurt. He could try to cripple Triple H, and then, even though he didn't work here, they'd be talking about Benoit all over the world.
King, I have to agree with you there, but you got to give Triple H credit. Whether you like him or you don't like him, he's a competitor. He is the game. He is the World Wrestling Federation champion.
Right.
And he's going to go one-on-one with Benoit here tonight.
Right. And that man right there, the game, when you're the WWF champion, I mean, you are a multi-million dollar athlete. That's what that title means to you here. And he's going to risk that against Chris Benoit, who, like I said, he's got nothing to lose. He's also got nothing to win. It's a dangerous situation.
Extremely dangerous for Triple H. And here comes his opponent.
And his opponent from Edmonton, Alberta, Canada, weighing in at 225 pounds, Chris Benoit.
And there he is, Michael. Chris Benoit in his first and his last ever WWF match.
Well, think of the emotional roller coaster ride that Benoit and his three comrades have been on here tonight on SmackDown. Dean Malenko lost to X-Pac. But in a match that Eddie Guerrero and Perry Saturn had won against the New Age Outlaws,
what?
Guerrero fell on hard luck, dislocating his elbow.
And
in my opinion, it should be one-to-one going into this match, Ken.
Your opinion? You make a valid point, but that's just not the way it was. They never had the match won. They'd had the match won, it would be one-to-one. But they didn't, and they lost. And now Chris Benoit is standing there, and I guess he's trying to concentrate on Triple H, but part of his mind has got to be on his friend's elbow in a hospital there.
Yeah, Eddie Guerrero, taken to a Detroit medical center. And Triple H trash-talking with Chris Benoit. Do you see the look of the intensity in Chris Benoit's eyes, King? He has a lot to prove here tonight. So what if this is just a cup of coffee for Chris Benoit? He has something to prove to the game here tonight on SmackDown.
Yeah, he'd love to hurt the game. He'd love to put the game in the hospital just like Eddie Guerrero's in the hospital. And then everybody be talking about Eddie Guerrero.
And Benoit reverses like in the corner, going to work on Triple H, and Triple H reverses it right back. You're right, Chris Benoit is extremely dangerous. It's like a wounded dog. His team's been knocked down. The emotion's been drained out of him.
I call him Eddie Guerrero. I can't even get these guys' names straight. I don't even want to become familiar with him. I'm glad this is the only night we're going to see him. They got a one-night work permit, and now they're out of here. What's that say on the back of Benoit's tights?
As Triple H backs Chris Benoit into the corner.
Crippler. See, that's what he'd like to do to Triple H. It's his whole mindset. Benoit would like to cripple somebody here.
Triple H went for the right hand, and Benoit just floored him with a right of his own. The champion back on his feet. Look out, takedown by Benoit. He's going for the crippler crossface. His finishing maneuver, and Triple H wisely rolled out underneath the bottom rope. If Benoit had locked in the crippler crossface, it would have been lights out for the champion. As Triple H wisely ducked underneath the bottom rope. I don't like the look on Triple H's face. I think he's sort of in a state of shock here. He realizes now that this could have been a mistake he's made.
You know, emotions do strange things. Chris Benoit has been on an emotional ride all night long on SmackDown. If he can channel that energy, the game is in for a huge awakening here.
I know, you know, he's come a long ways, had a long, rough road. Oh! Wrestle up Canada, then down Atlanta. So what? Big deal. He's getting his one and only shot here in the WWF.
The game with the right hands to Chris Benoit. Triple H said he made this match because of the goodness in his heart.
Right, that is goodness.
How is that goodness?
Well, I mean, by rights, Benoit shouldn't even, he should be accompanying Eddie Guerrero to the hospital right now.
Knife edge chops kicked in the midsection for Benoit. Triple H ripped off the rug. Oh, down by an elbow by Benoit to the face of the champion.
What an idiot that Benoit is.
Foot snap suplex by Chris Benoit, and Triple H in trouble, and again, the game wisely rolling out underneath the bottom rope.
Again, what
baseball slide! Triple H into the barricade. You were right, King, you hit the nail on the head.
He kicked our WWF champion right in the face.
An extremely dangerous situation for Triple H to be in. And perhaps the game was a bit overconfident, King.
Watch yourself, Stephanie, don't get too close to that action.
Perhaps the game was a bit overconfident. Oh, what a takedown by Triple H. Head first, head bouncing off the steel steps.